Keto diet for endurance. In my last video, I explained why the keto diet kills athletic performance in terms of strength and power. But what about for endurance athletes? In this video, I'll tell you what research on elite athletes tells us. Hi, this is Dr. Shintani for your health. In my last video, I explained why ketogenic diets kill your peak performance. To see that video, subscribe to this channel and click the bell and look for my last video. Basically, I showed research that demonstrated that peak power and mean power was decreased on a ketogenic diet compared to a high-carb diet. It makes sense that peak performance is better with a high-carb diet because the energy for bursts of strength is produced using carbohydrates anaerobically. So for short-term to moderate-duration exercise, it's quite clear that a high-carb diet will get you better results. However, for endurance athletes, research is ongoing to see if a ketogenic diet may have some advantages. There's some logic to this. You see, the body will use carbs first if it's available and burn fat only when it runs out of carbs. So until you run out of carbs, it makes sense that a high-carb diet will be better. But what if you participate in a sport that routinely takes you beyond your carbohydrate stores? While it varies greatly from person to person, an average 155-pound body stores approximately 500 grams of carbs in the muscle and 100 grams of carbs in the liver. This provides roughly 2,400 calories of energy storage in the form of glycogen. If you estimate 150 calories required for a mile of running, then a marathoner will run out of carbs at about 16 miles. Then, when you run out of carbs, your body has to switch over to burning fats. This changeover can cause a period of extreme fatigue and brain fog as blood sugar runs out. This is commonly called bonking in endurance sports. Then, after the body adjusts, it starts to burn fats instead, and the ketosis from the fat burning improves mood and endurance. Some endurance athletes believe that to eliminate bonking, they would stay on a ketogenic diet so that they are already adapted to burning fats and then they don't have to go through the adjustment. Research is coming up with conflicting results on this approach. Some research indicates that endurance performance goes down on a ketogenic diet, showing a decrease in time to exhaustion, decreased peak power, and inability to undertake high-intensity bouts. Other research suggests that if ketosis is sustained long enough prior to engaging in endurance activity, performance may increase overall. Still, other research indicates that a ketogenic diet has advantages during high-volume, low-intensity training, but decreases the ability to perform high-intensity work during the last 15 minutes of their exercise protocol. In other words, the ketogenic diet is better for endurance training, but may make it more difficult to win a close race with a burst of speed at the end. The reality is that none of these studies are without flaws or are large enough to draw definitive conclusions. Researchers are now conducting studies to sort this out. In the meanwhile, I think it's useful to look at what some of the best-known long-distance runners do in terms of their diets. In my next video, I'll cover research on what champion elite endurance athletes, including Olympic gold medalists, do for their diets. Be sure to subscribe to this channel and click the bell for notification for this and other tips on health and vibrant longevity. This is Dr. Shintani for your health.